You may have already heard of the free and open source application repository called F-Droid, but here today I want to highlight an application called Droidify that combines the repositories of F-Droid, IzzyOnDroid, popular modules for Xposed, and many more. This way, you don't have to use three separate app stores just to install, update, and manage applications from these sources. And I'll be sure to link to the Droidify GitHub page down in the video description below. So the first thing that you may notice is how the application looks different than F-Droid. And while I don't really mind the design of F-Droid, I do think that they could make better use of the space. So F-Droid defaults us to this page, but we can then dive into specific categories and then pick an application from there. While with Droidify, you are automatically brought into an Explore tab where you can go and begin browsing, and we have access to our categories from here. And we can dive into an application from there as well. So we're able to manually install or update from the app page. You can see we have this nice gallery right here to see the images. We have our app description. And then we have drop-down menus that reveal links, sometimes a donate page, and the permissions that are required for the application. At the bottom, we also have access to older versions of the application. Functionally, these are all visible within the F-Droid app page as well, but many would say that the design of Droidify just looks much better in their eyes. There are a number of different ways that you can find and browse within this repository. The default list here will be sorted by showing the latest updates at the top, but we can change this to show the newest apps up here, or we can sort them by name. We have a refresh button that will grab all of the new data from the enabled repositories. And again, as I mentioned, we can dive into specific categories directly from that Explore page. Now, looking into the settings page, we can tap on the three-dot menu up here and then tap on settings. And here we can change the language, we can change the theme, we can enable material U color. We have the ability to enable automatic updates. And down here, we have the ability to import or export the repositories that it will connect to. And that's really where I think Droidify shines. The ability to easily enable or disable dozens of different repos that it will connect to. These repositories can be manually added to F-Droid as well, but how many people want to go through that manual entry process? So if we tap on the three-dot menu up here at the top right, you can see there is an option for repositories. And here we can see all the different repos that can be quickly enabled or disabled within the application. By default, you'll only have F-Droid and IzzyOnDroid F-Droid repositories enabled, but you can see that there are a lot of different ones to choose from. So for those who like the Bromite web browser, we can tap on that repo and it will instantly download the data from the repository so that it's available within the app. And again, there are a lot of different repos to choose from, If you don't see one that you're looking for, the bottom right, you'll see a fab button that you can tap to manually enter the details for that repository. The enabled repositories can be easily accessed via the category dropdown. So as you saw, I enabled the bromite one, and then when I tap it, I get access to all of the apps available in that repository. And I also like that Droidify already has a category for Xposed that includes a number of modules that can be installed and updated directly from here. If you're a fan of free and open source software for Android, then I highly recommend checking out the Droidify application store today. It offers more than what you can just get out of F-Droid, while also being able to replace F-Droid entirely, even if you only use it to access the F-Droid repo for true free and open source software applications and games. And as mentioned, you can find the link to download the latest version of Droidify down in the video description below. And before I forget, please remember to like this video while also subscribing to the channel, as it really helps us out.